is a time series stationary?
To answer this question, recall that a time series is a sequence of data points indexed in temporal order, and that the value of the data point associated with timestamp t can be seen as a sample of a random variable xt. By definition, a time series is stationary if the joint probability distribution of all its random variables xt does not change over time. However, a weaker definition of stationarity is more commonly employed in data science and signal processing, and this is our focus today. A time series is weakly stationary if two conditions are satisfied. First, all of its random variables xt follow distributions with a constant population mean, and second, the population autocovariance between random variables xt and xt plus k depends only on k, which is the length of the lag between them. Note that a weakly stationary time series has no trends because of its constant population mean and population autocovariance. A white noise time series, also known as random shock, is a great example of weak stationarity. Its random variables have a constant population mean and are uncorrelated. It does not matter at which point in time you observe the white noise. It should basically look the same at any point in time.
Why is weak stationarity important?
Most traditional forecasting methods are not suited for time series that are not stationary and have trends or seasonality. In fact, time series forecasting models often rely on the assumption that the data is at least weakly stationary and that its random variables are independent from each other. When faced with a non-stationary time series, it is possible to use differencing, a method that computes the differences between consecutive observations, to make it stationary. Logarithmic data transformations can also help stabilize the statistical properties of a time series, reducing or eliminating trend and seasonality.